Okay, we'd like to welcome you back to our study today. This is part two of our study. And we left off by me stating that Nisan 1 approximately starts on March 12th. Okay, that's the first month of the Hebrew calendar, God's calendar year. Okay, Nisan 1. And it approximately starts on March 12th. How can we determine that? Well, back in biblical times, the days and the times were determined by the new moon of each month, okay? And it's the same thing today, the way God views it. It's God's timing, it's God's timeline, and so he views time different than we do. This is why I say approximately. Because a day is 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is as a day to God. So it's really hard to get an approximate or an exact. But this is a very probable situation here, okay, that we're going to be looking at. So let's review this real quick. I'm going to back up what I'm saying here to the best that I can. Here we have the calendar month of March of 2013, okay? And the new moon falls anywhere between here and here, okay? So possibly here is going to be the start of Nisan 1, okay? So that means 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, that means Passover would fall somewhere in this area here. Possibly, probably on the 25th. Easter is right here this year, on March 31st. So there's no similarities between Easter and Passover. Get that out of your head right now. Easter is a pagan holiday. Stems from the god Ishtar. Okay, fertility goddess. It's a fertility rite based off the spring equinox. Has nothing to do with Christianity. So approximately Passover would be here. It'd be Nisan 14. Okay. The Jews celebrate their Passover the day after, because it was a Passover, the Lord's Passover, that he was crucified on the 14th. And they celebrated it on the 15th, okay? So, you know, that's like I said, that's another topic for another video. Now, how can we determine this? Well, again, we're looking at approximates here. This is a fraction of the moon illuminated chart here. I don't know if you can see this clearly, but we're going to be looking at March. Excuse me, March here, okay, and I got this set at noon Eastern Standard Time. The reason why I got this set at noon Eastern Standard Time is because it's more likely sunset over there in Israel or whatever, you know, so I got it set at noon. Now, on March the 12th, you see right here, March 11th, it's you know, a blank moon, basically. There's 0% illumination. A lot of times people look for the sliver of the new moon. But again, we got to think of it in God's timing, not ours. Our naked eye can't pick up the sliver on the 12th. It's only 1% illuminated. I mean, you would have to really, really look. You probably can pick it up, but these are just estimations, these are calculations. But March the 12th, the moon will be 0.01% illuminated. So that would start Nisan the 1st. Okay. You go to the calendar here, March 13th. This is where it would start, right here. Passover would be right here. Okay. They probably have, they actually, this one probably has a calculation right. Tuesday, March the 12th. Okay. Now, hopefully I kind of cleared that up, because this is going to be very important that I'm going to be talking about here. We're going to be getting into these three numbers here in this video. Now, can we understand that history repeats itself, yes or no? Yes, very easily. Ecclesiastes 1:9. The thing that hath been, it is that which shall be, and that which is done is that which shall be done, and there is no new thing under the sun. So, over and over and again, in the Old Testament, we read over and over again the children of Israel, the Jews, and everything, going after false gods. So it is no surprise that the thing that hath been, it is that which shall be, and that which is done is that which shall be done. There is no new thing under the sun. So it should be no surprise that the Jews of today, who are unbelievers, are going at their false gods, possibly sacrificing unto them. It should be no surprise, if you look at the term Barabbas, and I've done this many times, the term Barabbas, who was a murderer, means son of the father. So Barabbas means, and they accepted a murderer and crucified the Messiah, the Son of God. Okay, so they accepted a false Christ, a false son, for the true son. There's no new thing under the sun. What's going to happen here at the end? They're going to accept a false God and reject the true God. Now, obviously, there's going to be a one-third remnant that gets saved out of it. And Jesus himself said, I will not return unto you until you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Okay, so now we're going to go back to Matthew 24:15. When you therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet stand in the holy place, whoso readeth, let him understand. Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. Here we see that word flee. Let him which is on the housetop not come down to take anything out of his house. Neither let him which is in the field return back to take his clothes. And woe unto them that are with child, and to them that give suck in those days. But pray ye that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day. It's a little clue there. We're going to get to it. For there shall be great tribulation, such as will not since the beginning of the world, to this time, no nor ever shall be. So, we got quite a bit of things happening here. We have the abomination of desolation being set up. We have Judea fleeing into the mountains, and we have a fleeing. This is all taking place before the 1260-day tribulation, or Great Tribulation. So, what does that tell you? Well, we're going to get into it. I'm not going to get into all the calculations here. I want to make this as simple as possible. If you look at this calendar, okay, if you look at this calendar, we kind of got an approximate that chances are Nisan the first will fall right here. Okay. Chances are Jesus will return. Actually, he will return on one of the fall feasts. More than likely on the Feast of Trumpets, okay? Rosh Hashanah is a Talmudic term. I'm not going to use that. Okay? And if you count backwards, 1,260 days to all the way, I believe that's 2017 or whatever, all the way to, and if you count backwards, 1,260 days from that, okay, you're going to come up with Nisan 11 right here. All right. Right here and here and here. It cannot fall here and anywhere. Why? Because these are still the winter dates. These are still the winter dates. This is the first day of spring. So it could fall here or here. But how ironic that this whole portion of scripture right here. But pray that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day, falls exactly before the Sabbath, after the winter, right there. So could this be when this whole fleeing takes place? Could this be when the abomination of desolation is set up and the sacrifices cease? We're coming close to this time period. So it's all a matter of waiting and seeing, basically, if this pans out the way it's, you know, the way the calculations are showing. Okay, again, these are approximates. I'm not saying for sure 100% this is going to happen, but March 22nd could be a very big day. Now, and obviously, for then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be. Okay, so we're going to move to Daniel 12:11. We're going to look at this abomination of desolation. And from the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1,200. In 90 days. Well, wait a minute. I thought the tribulation was 3.5 years, 1,260 days. Yes, it is. So obviously there is a 30-day window of something going on. It'll take you back to the calendar here. Okay. You count backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, Twelve, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So, 30 days prior to the tribulation starting, you add 30 to 1,260, you get 1,290. We're going to get into this. So, pay attention to this date. I want you to mark these dates down. February 10th. Okay, but make sure you emphasize that these are probables. These are approximates. I'm not saying this for sure. Okay, so February 10th, mark that down. What is that? Well, hopefully we might be able to get some understanding out of this. I am learning this just as much as you are. Okay, so now, blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1,305 and 30 days. Okay? So, 1,335 days, basically. Okay, that's what that is. Now, let's look at this word daily. I don't like doing this whole thing because it's in italics. Leave this word out. Okay? Because there's some very dangerous things you can do with that if you take all these italicized words out. I just leave them in there. Okay, and I see nothing wrong with leaving them in there. So let's look at this for a minute. From the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away. So what's the daily? Well, the daily comes from the word tamid, tamid. Almost sounds like Talmud. Tamid, okay. From an unusual root meaning to stretch, properly continuance as indefinite extension, but used only attributively as adjective, constant, or adverbially, consistently, elliptically, the regular, daily sacrifice, always, continual, employment, daily, never, more, perpetual. So something perpetual, daily, employment. Okay, you're working for something. What are you working for? Kind of interesting. Continuity, perpetuity to stretch, continually, continuously, and continuity. Okay, now let's look at this term, sacrifice shall be taken away. Comes from the verbiage sorsor. Okay, a primitive root to turn off, literally or figuratively. You're going to see that this does not have to be animal sacrifices. Very important that we understand that. Figuratively, behead, bring, call back, decline, depart, eschew, go, aside, grievous, lay away, leave undone, be passed, pluck away, put away. Look at this one, rebel. Remove, revolt, be sour, take away, turn, aside, away. So we have these words that are very interesting. Revolt, rebel, be sour, lay away, pluck away. Revolt, remove, rebel. That could almost be like bloodshed. That could almost maybe sound like a war. Let's not think of that as not being out, that's not out, that's not out of the stretch of imagination. I mean, that could literally be what that is. What are the talks that were that's going on in the Middle East? Okay, I mean, it's like you got Ahmadinejad, who believes that the only way the fifth Imam, Imam Mahdi, and a lot of the other Muslims, the Shiites and stuff like that, the only thing that could bring about their Messiah is through much bloodshed. The Jews basically believe the same thing. Again, there is no new thing under the sun. If the ancient Jews and if ancient Israel were sacrificing unto other gods, human sacrifice, why is it out of the stretch of the imagination that there are Jews, Talmudic Jews today, who are doing the same thing? Clearly, they are not going after the God of the Bible, because they crucified the God of the Bible, who came in the flesh. Okay, so when you therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place. Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. So, let's look at this in a possible act of war. Could this 30-day period, from March 10th until the flight, right here, be a 30-day war? This is an article. I'm not going to read the article. This is an older article. This is from August. August of this year. Okay. Look at this headline. Israeli minister warns of 30-day war with Iran. I think that's very fitting that they just specifically said 30-day war. with all the chaos that's going to be going on with this World War III and everything like that, you can understand why it's only going to last 30 days. It's going to be a massive bloodshed, mass chaos throughout the world, not just in the Middle East. So with this massive bloodshed, this false Christ, this false Messiah can appear and bring order out of chaos. Peace, peace, and all of a sudden sons of destruction cometh upon them. And it sets up this abomination of desolation, possibly on this date right here. And the Great Tribulation would start. Let us not throw away the fact that this whole thing, revolt, remove, to and fro, rebel, could also mean, or behead. This could also be talking about literal mass human sacrifice to bring about the one world order and their God, to set up the abomination of desolation. When you therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet standing in the holy place, whoso readeth, let him understand. Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. We kind of covered what that was. Okay. But pray ye that your flight be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath day. We did that. So we kind of discovered when the Great Tribulation would take place. These are all approximate dates, folks. Mark down February 10th, March 22nd, 2013. Number 13 is a number of rebellion. Rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft. Now, this is just a kind of like a little mini chart here I put together. So, from this point here to this point here is 30 days. Okay? This could possibly be sacrifices started up. This could be World War III. Okay? Mass bloodshed. Then we have a flight. We have the fleeing. You know, fleeing into the mountains. Starting here, the abomination set up. Great Tribulation begins. 1,260 days plus 30 days is 1,290 days. And then you come to this point. We are protected through the wrath of God. God has not appointed us to wrath. Could it possibly be that the wrath of God lasts 45 days? Well, you only have 45 days less, you know, left to figure out to 1,335 days. So 1,290 days plus 45 days equals 1,335 days. Right here. Okay. So, this is all I'm going to share with you today. This is probably a lot to soak in, but I want to state for the record one more time that I am not saying this is a for sure thing. I am going to say that this is astounding how all of this lines up so perfectly. Okay. But I'm in no way, shape, or form saying that this is exactly going to happen on this day and on this time. But what I will say is that when you see the abomination of desolation take place, and you will, you'll know that the Great Tribulation has begun. And you will be able to count 1,260 days. And you will approximately arrive, or 1,290 days, and you will approximately arrive to the very last fall feast day, basically. And then you will have all 1,335 days accounted for. So, it's a very fascinating topic. And, you're not going to hear this in any of these churches out there. I mean, you're not going to hear any of this, what I went over. But I do strongly advise that you look at everything I showed you. Write all the verses down. I'll provide you with the links of the articles I showed you. Okay? And all I can say is leave me your comments. Okay, I can't put a stamp on this. All I did was show you a scripture, but at the same time, I could be wrong on this whole interpretation of this. So that's why I'm stating for the record that this is all approximate. I'm not saying it's for sure. So I hope you enjoyed this. Until next time, truth be told, truth be known, stay safe, God bless, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.